Defence Secretary Gotabaya Rajapaksa Friday reiterated that the defeat of the LTT was accomplished amid a massive external pressure by certain Western governments.
First, the eastern province was cleared. Then attention turned to the northern campaign straight away. At no point was there any stoppages. No opportunity was given for the LTT to regroup and reorganize. Instead, from the first day of the campaign until the demise of Prabhakaran at the Nandikadal Lagoon, there was consistent, continuous progress. This progress was achieved despite setbacks occurring from time to time. Such setbacks are inevitable in any undertaking, but so long as the key people remain focused on the end objective, they will not impact the final outcome.
Rajapaksa was speaking at the 7th annual conference of the MBA Alumni Association of the Colombo University.
During the last stages of the war, when certain Western governments with Western interests tried to intervene and halt the progress of the military, the firm resolve and commitment of the leadership body was very clear to see. The president, as commander-in-chief, was the only person who could call an end to the war. He held firm in the face of immense pressure. The French foreign minister and the British foreign secretary even came to Sri Lanka to try and influence him to change his mind. Despite this last-minute interference, the president did not waver. As a result of his firm resolve and unwavering commitment, the Western pressure was resisted and the final objective was achieved.
Sri Lanka is targeting $12 billion in exports in 2012, up from $10.4 billion in 2011, which will be helped by an upcoming trade fair and a weaker rupee, Export Development Board Chief Janaka Ratnayake said. Ratnayake said if current trends continue, exports may reach a 2015 target of 15 billion rupees earlier than expected.
And it is very encouraging to note that last 2 years, we have been having a tremendous improvement in exports, having achieved almost 22 plus the growth rate in exports. If you look at the figures for last 2011, exports to EU and USA grown up by 25%. The reason is that we produce some of the best products. If you look at all these international brands, apparel is the number one exporter, having almost 4.5 billion income generated through exports. They produce some of the best brands. Mark and Spencer, like Victoria's Secret, you name any brand we produce. So our specialties in our exports is that we produce best products, we give the best services as exports.
But Sri Lanka's exports increased over 20 for 2 years running with a stable rupee at 110 to the US dollar. A currency depreciation increases profits of an export firm by cutting real wages of workers.
යුරෝපයේ කියලා මුළු ලෝක ආර්ථිකය අද යුරෝපේ නේ තියෙන ආසියාවේ ආර්ථිකය තියෙන. ඉතින් යුරෝපේ වැටුණාට අපි වැටෙන්නේ නැහැ. ඒ යුරෝපේ අපිට තර්ජනය කරත් අපේ ස්වයං විභාවයට හානි කරන්න හැදුවත් අපි යට වෙන්නේ නැහැ. ඉතින් ඒක හන්දා අපි මේක ඉච්චර ලොකු දෙයක් නෙවෙයි. අපි යුරෝපයට අනිත් පාර සමහර වෙලාවට අපි ණය දෙන්නත් ඉඳ තියෙනවා හිතන්න.
Ratnayake said an upcoming Export 2012 trade fair to kick off on March 28th will help Sri Lanka boost exports.
We are very happy to say that we have got a tremendous, overwhelming response from the foreign visitors. We have getting a huge number almost on everyday basis. The number has surpassed almost 1,000 up to now. And it's very difficult even to get additional rooms in Colombo. The hotel rooms are also fully booked. Now in this Expo 2012 event, we are not only targeting trade. It will be a trade event where our leading exporters will display their products and services. And we will have a symposium as well. The symposium will be attended by world-renowned speakers to talk about the experience and the share their knowledge.
State-owned National Savings Bank on Friday marked its 40th anniversary. NSB was opened for business on 16th March 1972. It was established in 1971 by a Parliament Act. National Savings Bank actively engaged in the field of mobilization and promotion of domestic savings in Sri Lanka while upholding the institutional banking culture in the country.
එක දුරදක්නා නුවණක් තියෙන දේශපාලඥයෙක් දිවංගත ආචාර්ය එන්.එම්. ප්‍රණමැතිතුමා මුදල් ආක්‍රම සම්බන්ධ අමාත්‍ය ලෙස මේ සුවිශේෂී වූ අග්‍රගණ්‍ය මූල්‍යමය ආයතනය ස්ථාපිත කරා එයින් සිය සෑම සියලු ලක්වාසී සියලු දෙනාටම විශාල ප්‍රතිලාභයක් ලැබුණා රජයටත් පවතින ආණ්ඩුවලටත් විශාල ප්‍රතිලාභ අවුරුදු ගණන් අවුරුදු පුරා ලැබුණා හැබැයි මිත්‍රවරුනි හිතවරුනි ජාතික ඉදිරිගමන් බැංකුවේ පෙර දිව්වෙත් වර්තමානයේ දුවන්නේ ඉදිරියට ගෙන යන්නේ දේශපාලඥයෝ නෙවෙයි හිතවතුන් මිත්‍රවරු ඒක ඔබක් හිතේ තියාගන්න සුදුසාට සුදුසු තැන දීමේ ප්‍රතිපත්තිය හැම විටම අනුගමනය කරන බවට මේ සභාපති ඔබට ස්ථිරසාර ප්‍රතිඥාවක් දෙනවා මම මේ පුටුවේ සභාපතිත්වයේ දරණකම් මේ ප්‍රතිඥාව එහෙමම තියෙනවා මං ගිය දාට මං දන්නේ වෙන සභාපති කැවිලා මං කරපු දේ ඉදිරියට ගෙන යා යුතුයි කියන පදනමේ විශ්වාසය තමයි මේ සභාපති ඉන්නේ
At a brief ceremony held at NSB head office in Kolpiti, an employee was awarded for his 40 years of service at the bank. Singer, partnering with Godrej, introduced a high-tech stylish range of refrigerators under the brand Godrej Eon. Godrej said, with the right partner, their brand will be successful in Sri Lanka as they are in India.
India and Sri Lanka shares a lot of similarities in culture, in religion, in taste, in habits, in lifestyle. And I think as a result, whatever is successful in India must be successful in a country like Sri Lanka. Another thing also about Godrej in Sri Lanka, I think we are present in this country. This brand is a known brand in this country. We are present in this country for the last 15 years. Rightly said by Sonali, the most popular being hair dye, and I don't know how many of you are already using it here. So it's a very popular product, it's a very popular brand. In appliances, we have been present in this country for the last 10 years, but I think we have not made any headway in